Okay, Nigel, thank you for joining me today to chat more about marine electrical and electrical solutions, electronic solutions on boats. Thank you for carving out the time. This is the boat show season, so a lot of people are busy dreaming about how to make their boats better. And with that in mind, I just wanted to kick off a little bit. I know that you've been promoting and doing sharing your knowledge with your courses online. And as a good segue to the stuff that you see within the course that you're teaching, and please feel to elaborate on this as well. Do you want to share with us a little bit about the common questions or the common things that your students are searching to, you know, become better at? What are the things that boaters you think are seeking these days from what you're seeing in your course?
Well, I think our boats are also electrically loaded these days, and we've got so much equipment on them, refrigerators, hot water heaters, all the navigation electronics and so on, that fundamentally anybody that's going to take a boat offshore has to have a basic understanding of boat electrics. And that's what we focus in on our basic electrical course. We start from electrons and we work our way up to a whole boat system. In between, we cover putting together the wiring, the terminals, sizing everything, putting the overcurrent protection on, battery chargers, alternators, all the bits and pieces that we have on all of our boats today. Every one of us has these bits and pieces. And the idea is to give people an overall view of what it takes to make your system work well and to make them work safely. I've done hundreds of surveys of boat systems over the years, and I've almost never got on a boat, including all the new boats I've surveyed, that was fully compliant in terms of, for example, overcurrent protection. And then I see all kinds of errors with respect to too many terminals on one post. Well, you know, you see the stuff yourself. So the goal is to give everybody a basic understanding of their electrical systems and to do it in a way that's understandable. And bit by bit, we build up through, I don't know, how many lessons have we got in there? 59, I think. So it takes a certain amount of perseverance on the part of the end users, but I think if somebody works their way through that system, they'll have a pretty good grasp of all the basics that they need for certainly for a boat DC system. We don't get into AC systems in that first course; we treat them separately in another course.
Yeah, it's a journey.
But you must see this all the time, Jeff. You get on boats and you see all kinds of things that are just fundamentally wrong. And then it's not rocket science. These are simple mistakes that the boat builders make, or the worst of the boat owners that do their own wiring without having acquired the knowledge. And they put all kinds of lousy systems on boats, and then they cause trouble all the time, and then they get frustrated, and they want to go skiing instead of sailing. And so part of the goal of what we're doing is to make people enjoy their boating more so that they don't have to spend hours and days troubleshooting problems on the boats.
Yeah, you bring a good point, and I try to inspire people through it. It's sort of like it's a personal Everest is the way I describe it. You know, boat ownership is really, we all push ourselves differently, but it's a challenging situation. It's a situation that requires, like you say, dedication to learn the systems, to be a better boater, and electrical is just one part of it. Electronics is another one. There's all these different sort of facets to boating, and you're right, no boat is I've never seen a perfect boat electrically. Some are closer than others, for sure. And I think as a boat owner, you know, the courses, and I remember doing the same thing, you know, the blogs and all this, just educating oneself to get to closer, as close as you can to what it should be. And that takes a lot in learning what should, right? I mean, there's a lot of debate on pros and cons for everything. So yeah, good on you to kind of pass on that knowledge and help everybody else along their journey, because it's a hardest one. It's not for the meek of heart, but it's totally worth it when it works and you feel reliable.
We've made it tough on ourselves. When I first went boating, we didn't have an electrical system on the boat. We sailed from England to Amsterdam, and we have one device that required a battery, which was a depth sounder that didn't work. We actually had a long line. And aside from that, we had kerosene lanterns and so on. So it was much easier then. All we needed to understand was how to raise and set the sails and how to do basic piloting skills. We didn't need all these other skills. So we have kind of imposed this on ourselves. But having done it, we've got much more comfortable lifestyles on our boats. But if they're not going to frustrate the hell out of us, we have to understand the underlying systems behind them, and we have to make sure they're installed properly. And if they are, then they'll run for years and sometimes decades without creating problems for people. But it's getting that insulation right in the first place that's really critical.
Yeah, so true.
You know, and I've learned this stuff the hard way over the years. It's not like I've come into this knowing all this stuff. I've been at this for 40 years now, and I've made pretty much every mistake in the book. Most of the mistakes in my own books. So, but the bottom line here is it's not rocket science. It's something that anybody that's willing to apply themselves to can learn. We're not having to deal with complicated algorithms and formulas and stuff. It's all fairly simple. It's just there's an awful lot of it. And we have to get all the bits and pieces correct.
Yeah, so true. So true. It's okay to be humbled. You know, that's the whole point. Making errors and learning from it is part of boat ownership. It's like learning a bike, to ride a bike, but not at 4 years old like some of us do, but learning it at older age when we're not maybe comfortable falling down all the time. You know, not literally, but figuratively. You know, it's the lessons are hard on a boat, and especially to keep the systems that we've learned to love and give us, like you say, the creature comforts that we've come accustomed to, like refrigeration, heat, lighting, navigation system, entertainment systems. Some of us will partake in some of those, and to keep those systems up and run them reliably takes a good understanding of how they work, especially if you ever are called upon troubleshooting. Troubleshooting is the hardest of them all. It relies on oneself understanding how it works to figure out what's broken. So but you know what? I mean, if it was easy, it's like golf. If it was easy, if boating was easy, many of us wouldn't be doing it. It's certainly what calls me to it, is that it is challenging. Yeah. On the topic.
Also, the other big difference to falling off a bike is that it's a lot more expensive to fix the problem.
Oh, yeah.
You fall off a bike and you skin your knee and it's self-healing.
Not on a boat.
All it takes is time. But with boat systems, you screw it up, it's a lot more expensive sorting it out.
Yeah, so true. You want to get it right as close as you can the first time. Although we all make mistakes, myself included, along the journey, lots.
So if you're curious again, go on our website and find out more answers and solutions with this sort of setup. And thanks for asking. And thanks for all of you for listening and tuning in.